Josh Newham, lifetime drug-free bodybuilder, and you're watching Natural Aesthetics. In this video, I'm going to explain how I've built my arms over the years, the exercises that I've done, the various protocols that I've followed, and any special techniques that I've utilized on certain exercises. Also, I'll give you an example program that you can use for yourselves. Before I start though, if I could ask you to subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already to see more true natural bodybuilding content. Also, if you can click on the notification button, the little bell icon, to be made aware of any videos I upload automatically. Currently, only 7% of my subscribers are actually notified when I upload a video, so if you could do that, that'd be great, thank you. Okay, so I'm training. My current regime is probably a little bit different from what it has been typically. Can't train biceps with as much vigor or volume as I have done due to golfer's elbow. It's kind of on the mend at the moment, almost there, but it's really since lockdown, I haven't been able to train biceps as I would usually. So my arms are probably a little bit downsized. I think at the moment they're about 16.5 inches cold, 17 with a pump. I think once that injury is over and I've had a good couple of months of proper arm training, then I'll probably be able to push that back up to 17 inches standard as cold, or there or thereabouts. But arm size is irrelevant, it's how they look, that's the most important part. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to run through some considerations, some points for you to think about and apply to your training, and then a protocol at the end of the video that you could maybe try out for yourselves. Okay, so number one, forget the notion that your arms will grow sufficiently from compound movements alone. This is a complete fallacy. Your arms are never going to grow adequately by doing bench press, overhead press, squats, deadlifts. Unless you've got insane arm genetics, you have to work on your arms and you have to apply the same intensity, the same training principles as you would do for other body parts. It's just not going to cut it. Arms can't be an afterthought. If you want big arms, then you need to get serious about it. So whatever protocol that you decide to do, just ensure that you have enough time to train arms appropriately. Be it full body, push, pull, upper, lower, bro split. You have to make sure that it's a priority, and all too often, especially with the higher frequency approaches such as full body, arms are an afterthought thrown in at the end of the workout. Your energy's spent, you've done loads of compound movements, and you're also in a rush to probably get out of the gym because the compounds are taking so long. So it can sometimes be the downfall of the higher frequency program. So as long as you know and understand that you have to fit in that volume on the arms, then you can make those kind of programs work for arm training. So when I did some programs like Mad Cow, for example, most of my assistants' work was arms. So I would do the three main compound lifts each day, and then I'll probably do at least two arm exercises each day after those. So they can work. And one of the advantages of the bro split is that you can focus on arms properly for one day, or perhaps do buys or tries after one other muscle. So you've got plenty of energy and plenty of time to spend on that particular body part. Also, don't be scared about designing your protocol around arm training. If you're really unhappy with your arm size, you want them to be more developed, then you can design the program around your arm training. There's nothing wrong with that. It doesn't always have to be an afterthought. It doesn't always have to be less important than chest, back, or shoulders. It doesn't have to be like that. So if you're only training arms once a week at the moment and you're unhappy with your progress, then consider training arms twice a week. It will give you the option to do maybe one heavy or one light session and just allows you to do more sets overall per week, which will more than likely equate to more growth in the long run. Also, for a good portion of your arm training, you want to be focusing on what I'd call heavy arm exercises. So barbell curl, tricep dips, heavy bar push downs, maybe alternating dumbbell curl, exercises that allow you to lift more weight. And you can focus then on progressive overload on those exercises over a course of a training block, perhaps trying to add a little bit more weight each time. And then you can leave all the isolation exercises, maybe your kickbacks or tricep overhead extensions, concentration curls, cable curls, stuff like that, where you can just focus on kind of getting a really good contraction, getting a good pump, not being too intent on increasing the weight over the time, letting all the other compounds, the main movements, kind of drive your performance up within your arm training. And that's worked quite well for me over the years. Make sure that you structure your arm exercises just as you would do for other body parts. Don't go into the gym without a plan. It's very important that you stick more or less to the same exercises that you're doing for a number of weeks. Perhaps if you were doing two sessions, you could have one session that was very rigid in the exercises you're doing, the protocol you're doing, maybe focusing on progressive overload. And then the second session, you could maybe go a little bit more kind of freestyle, maybe have a couple of movements in there that you'd usually have, and then kind of pick what you want depending on how you feel. But I think at least some of the work needs to be very rigid and very organized and structured. So use a variety of rep ranges. 5 to 15 is a good number. Focusing on the lower rep ranges on some of the compound movements like barbell curl, for example, dips or pushdowns, bar pushdowns, that just work quite well with heavy loads. Some of the other exercises don't work as well. For example, maybe a single arm dumbbell extension, a kickback, or a concentration curl. They're not the best exercises to utilize heavy loads on. You can go higher reps on those, focusing on maybe, 3 to 5 exercises where you're, more towards the lower end of that rep scale. And I think that mixture works quite well. Try to do more sets per week. I know it sounds simple, but I often see, people complain about their arm training, they're only doing 6 to 10 sets a week. Try to double that. For the next 6 weeks, try to do 15 to 20 sets per week of arm training. In my opinion, if enough of those sets are intense, it will give you more potential for arm growth than doing 6 to 10 sets. You don't have to do 2 sessions a week. If you want to do 1, that's fine, but just make sure you have enough time to do more sets than you were doing previously. Also, utilize advanced techniques for your arm training. Because it's generally easier to recover from, not quite as debilitating as, say, your back or leg training, then you can make the most of rest pause or drop sets or forced reps, luciform curls, for example, to take that set past the point of failure more often. You have to use those techniques a little bit more sparingly when you're training other body parts because they're so damaging, they're so hard to recover from. But I think with arms, you can get away with that, so make the most of it. For maybe 2 exercises of each session, go past failure, utilize those techniques, and then maybe drop off the intensity on your other exercises where you're just banging out maybe a few more sets of moderate intensity, moderate weight, just to get a good pump. But for a good percentage of that particular session, try to go balls to the wall, max out the intensity. So really focus on feeling the muscles contract. It's really, really important. Even if you're doing heavier loads on, say, your compound movements like the heavy barbell curls, for example, or the pushdowns, I've gone as heavy as 4 to 6 reps and I still feel a really good pump when I do that. If you can get a pump doing heavy weights, 4 to 6 reps, and you're doing it right, because you're really in tune to how that muscle feels and you're really connected to it. So that's something I would really work on, whether you're doing high reps or low reps. You want to feel it and feel the muscle contract and try to get that pump. Now, this is really, really important. I don't see this in the gyms anywhere near enough, and that's training forearms. If you want really impressive arms, then you have to train forearms. You get a really kind of powerful, developed look. Just, think of the best arms in the FBB guys. All of them have fantastic forearms historically. Very hard to get good arms without good forearms, in my opinion. It's just a complete kind of look. And having small forearms might even hinder your ability to get upper arm growth. That I don't know, it's a theory, but for sure it looks less impressive. So work your forearms consistently. Over the last few years, I've been doing reverse curls with barbell and dumbbell wrist curls. Really, really simple, just 2 exercises to throw in there, and your forearms, will start to grow, and your overall arm look will look so much better, guys. So a few little quick tips before we move on to the example protocol. When you're doing tricep bar pushdowns, utilize a weight belt, maybe put 10, 15 or 20 kilos on. This just acts as a counterweight, holds you down, allows you to lift more weight on the triceps. You're not so worried about your core and kind of holding yourself down as the weight goes back up. So a really good tip to maximize the effectiveness of that exercise. When you're doing curls, especially with dumbbells, barbells, you're kind of more forced into a specific position anyway, but with dumbbells especially, really focus on twisting the little finger outwards towards the rear of the shoulder. So this is straight. Put your hand up now and feel the bicep, and then try and rotate your little finger outwards. The contraction is so much more intense. So lastly, for tricep dips, be it machine or on the parallel bars, don't go down all the way. If you go too low, maybe below the last 2/3 of the movement, you'll start to engage the chest too much. The chest will fatigue before the triceps, and you'll be hindering your ability to reach a high enough intensity on the triceps because the chest will go first. So just do the kind of top half, maybe top 2/3 of the movement at most, to maximize the amount of weight and intensity you can reach on the triceps. Okay, so I'm going to quickly run through a training protocol now. It's 2 arm workouts. The way you'd schedule this in, for example, you don't have to, would be the following. So Monday you do your push day, chest and shoulders. Tuesday would be arms, Wednesday legs, Thursday pulls or back and traps, and then Friday arms again, rest over the weekend. Very, very simple. You're more likely fast forward your arm development because you're focusing on that twice a week. Everything else is once a week. The first workout is a little bit heavier. Most of the work's being done in the 6 to 10 rep range. Barbell curl, 3 sets of 6 to 10. Looser form on the last set to crank out extra reps. So let's say you reach the point of fatigue on rep number 9. You then continue that set on maybe to 10 to 12 reps using a little bit of momentum. Still keeping it controlled, but you're just increasing the intensity of that set. You know, it's exactly the same as having a training partner and them spotting you. You're using momentum to achieve that same training intensity, if done correctly, you know, without being too loose. Tricep dips, 3 sets of 6 to 10, and continue the last set with negatives only. So once you've reached the point of fatigue, stand up on the foot platform and then lower yourself down, let's say 3 seconds, 1, 2, 3, you're at the bottom, there or thereabouts, and then you just stand back up and do it again. So whatever you did on that last set, let's say you got 8 reps, you probably want to do an extra 50%, so another 4 reps with the negatives to, again, just increase that intensity. Dumbbell curl, same principle as a barbell curl. Bar pushdowns, 3 sets again, 6 to 10 reps, but you utilize drop sets on the last set for around 4 to 8 reps. The drops want to be about 20 to 25% at the most. Not too light, because you're just going to end up doing endless reps and you're not really going to tax the muscle the way you need it to be taxed. You're going to work on other areas of fitness. So you just drop, let's say you do 9 reps on that last set and you reach that point of fatigue, drop the weight, maybe go for another 4 or 5, drop the weight again, probably looking at 4 or 5 again. So maybe around half, 60% of the reps you did on that original set. Reverse barbell curl, 4 sets of 8 to 12. Nothing too fancy on that, just make sure you keep your wrist rigid. A lot of people, when they do reverse curls, the wrist gets a little bit too much flexion, which isn't good. It takes away from the forearm effectiveness, so try and keep it rigid. Imagine your wrist is just attached to your forearm. It's all one unit. There's no movement of the wrist. So session 2 is slightly lighter. The first 2 exercises are done in superset fashion. So back to back, bar, cable, curl, rope, push down. So you can get on the same cable machine and just, you know, switch out the attachments. Really, really good way of training the arms, doing a lot of work in a relatively short period of time. So 5 sets of 8 to 12 reps. Ideally, you don't want to lower the weight once you start. So you kind of start on a weight that feels, you know, not too hard on the first set. By that 5th set, it's pretty difficult to reach that 8 to 12 rep mark. That's the ideal way to do it, really. Then you move on to seated incline dumbbell curl, one of my favourite exercises to do, 3 sets of 8 to 12. On the last set, you use rest pause to increase the rep count at that weight. So let's say you reach the point of failure at the 8th rep, you're really struggling on that last set, then you rest for 10 seconds, and then you go again. So you might get maybe 3 or 4 reps, you rest for a further 10 seconds, and then you go again, you might get maybe 2 or 3. But that massively increases the intensity of that set. Then you move on to easy bar overhead extensions. Nothing fancy on that one. Kind of a difficult exercise to use advanced techniques on. Can be a little bit dangerous. Obviously, the weight's back behind your head. So just keep it simple. 4 sets of 8 to 12 reps. Just bear in mind to try and keep the elbows locked in. Keep the weight almost as far back away from the neckline as possible. So you really, really stretch your triceps, go as low as you can, way past ear level, if not to the point where you can't see the bar because it's behind your shoulders. And then lock out nice and tight at the top. And then dumbbell wrist curls for the forearms to finish, 4 sets of 12 to 20. You can either sit down if the bench is low enough. If it's not low enough, you'll be going down at an angle, it just won't feel right, so you can kind of kneel down in front of the bench like the picture shows and put your forearms over the bench. Make sure your wrists are far enough away that the dumbbells don't kind of clank on the side of the bench as you lift up, which gets a little bit awkward. So that's my arm training protocol, just an example routine for you to follow. This would be perfect for someone that's been training for a few years but's unhappy with their arm development, has a good understanding of the training principles. I wouldn't recommend this for a beginner simply because of the reliance on looser form, advanced training techniques. This is perfect for someone that's just stuck at a plateau with their arm development. Give it a go. It's worked wonders for me in the past, you know, training twice a week with similar protocols such as this. If you try it, then let me know in the comments section. I'd be really interested in how it works for you. So I put a lot of effort into these videos, guys, so if you could please give it a thumbs up, really, really helps out, really appreciate it, thank you. If you want to see more true natural bodybuilding videos, then subscribe as well. Check out my Instagram page, the link is in the description box below. Stay strong.